Hey everyone, my name's Hunter Arthur. I'm a photographer and director based out of Brooklyn, New York. In this video, we're going to talk about four different ways to use the Nanlite Forza 500s. With hard light, you have really defined, crisp shadows, whereas soft light, you can't really tell where shadows end and the light begins. Now let's get started. It's really easy to make hard light. Personally, I like to take the reflector off. It creates a really strong, crisp shadow that mimics sunlight. I find a light that works well with the majority of people is a late afternoon sort of light. I put an Nanlite to the right or the left of the subject, raise it up and point it 45 degrees down at them. This is called Rembrandt lighting. It's a really great way to sculpt features of the face as well as make sure that the eyes aren't covered in shadow. When shooting hard light, sometimes you also want to be able to control the shadows. It's really easy to do this. You can take a second Nanlite and point it into the ceiling to create ambient light. This will fill the shadows. Or you can use the Nanlite Para 150 and point it directly at the subject. A lot of clients will want to mimic sunlight in the studio. It's important to be able to do this because oftentimes you're shooting spring, summer when it's actually winter outside and there's snow everywhere. You can't really do this on location, so you have to be able to do this in studio. And with the Nanlite Forza 500, it's a bright enough light to where you can shoot for beauty and jewelry, have that low ISO and high f-stop, and everything is still lit beautifully. We're going to show you a simple one-light beauty setup that I use for most of my beauty clients, as well as fashion clients. Take your Nanlite Forza 500, as well as the Nanlite Para 150, bring it close to your subject, either to the left or to the right. You can point it directly at your subject or you can feather the light, which means you point it slightly away and in front of them. Now take a white V-flat and bring it on the other side of your subject. We're bouncing light from the key light into the V-flat, which is going to fill in those shadows and create that really nice commercial beauty look. When shooting beauty, it's really important to have a strong light. I like the Nanlite Forza 500 because it's strong enough to shoot at f10, f11 with ISO 100. This is really important if you need to shoot for billboards or for video or stills. Nanlite is great because you have these really small, compact lights that are very powerful and you can use with really large modifiers that don't cost $10,000. You can use gels to correct color cast that a room is giving off, or you can use it to create different kind of effects like neon lighting or sunset. It's simple to do. You can either point a Nanlite directly into the ceiling with a gel on it, or you can use a Nanlite Para 150 and point it at your subject to light them evenly. Let's put a gel on our first light, and with this, we're just gonna create a nice color cast for the whole scene. This is great for a really nice, soft, ethereal feel, which works well for music videos or social videos. Now that we have our subject lit, we can use a second light to create what's called a rim light. A rim light is generally behind the subject to the side of them. This is great for creating strong silhouettes and separating the subject from the background. This is great for music videos, social videos, if you want to add interest to an image, if you want to color correct an image, or just add an overall feel and aesthetic. Blurring or freezing motion can be really important to your creative vision. It's really easy to do and intuitive, but often it's overlooked, and it's only achievable with consistent lighting. So for this setup, we just have a really easy beauty light. We have a Nanlite Forza 500 on the Nanlite Para 150 pointed at the subject, surrounded by white V-flats. This gives a really soft, consistent sort of lighting that works well for blurring motion or freezing motion. When we're outside shooting, it's really easy to either blur or freeze motion. When we bring that into the studio, it doesn't translate as well if we're only using strobes. Because the Nanlite Forza 500 is a consistent LED light, you have the option of both. You can either freeze motion if it's sporty or someone moving their hair or jumping around, or you can blur motion if you want to have that very specific creative vision to create atmosphere in your work. In a lot of editorial work, I find that people either freeze motion or blur motion using the same lighting setup. And they can do this because they're either shooting with natural light or they're shooting with a consistent light. You can't really change this easily when shooting with a strobe without changing your lighting setup. Using the Nanlite Forza 500s, it's really great because they're powerful enough to freeze motion, and because they're consistent light, you can also blur motion.